Welcome to Developing with DocuSign. I'm Carissa Jacobson, a member of the Developer Center team. In this screencast, I'll walk through installing and running the Ruby QuickStart on a Mac and the embedded signing code example. To follow along in this demo, you'll first need to download a Ruby QuickStart. If you haven't yet downloaded your Ruby QuickStart, please first follow the steps in the QuickStart overview page or the How to Download QuickStart video. QuickStart is a software wizard that packages a personalized code example launcher. You can choose from 8 programming languages. The QuickStart wizard configures an app in the developer's DocuSign account that can make API calls. These steps are completed for the developer. The launcher is downloaded from GitHub as a zip file, an integration key is created in the developer's account, a secret key is created to enable authorization code grant, an RSA key pair is created to enable JWT grant, redirection URLs are added, and the configuration file is modified with the developer's personalized information. You can find all the prerequisites for the Ruby QuickStart in the README on our GitHub page at github.com/docusign/code-examples-ruby. This README is also included in the QuickStart zip file. The README has a description of all of our API code examples with their source links to GitHub. In the installation prerequisites section, it says, note, if you downloaded this code using QuickStart from the DocuSign Developer Center, skip items 1 and 2 as they were automatically performed for you. To install and run the Ruby launcher, I'll need Ruby version 2.7.2 or later. If you're using a later version of Ruby, you'll need to update the gem file accordingly. In the installation steps in the README, it says, note, if you downloaded this code using QuickStart from the DocuSign Developer Center, skip step 4, as it was automatically performed for you. Next, it says, 1. Extract the QuickStart zip file or download or clone the code example's Ruby repository. The QuickStart automatically downloads into my downloads folder. I'll extract my QuickStart zip file into my source folder. Here in my extracted QuickStart folder, you can see that the QuickStart wizard appends a dash and the code language on the end of my QuickStart folder name. QuickStart enables developers to quickly run DocuSign code examples by configuring a launcher with the developer's account information. For the Ruby QuickStart, this configuration file is located in the config folder and is named appsettings.yaml. Aside from my email address and name, my unique integration key, integration secret, and impersonated user GUID are also displayed in the configuration file. In my DocuSign developer account, OAuth elements have DocuSign names. I can find these OAuth elements on the apps and keys page. My impersonated user GUID is called the API username and is located under my account information. My integration key can be found under apps and integration keys next to my app name, Tally Customer Portal. In addition, my integration secret is called a secret key and can be found by selecting the Actions button next to my app name, then choosing Edit. The secret key is located under Authentication. If I forget my secret key, I can create a new one by selecting Add Secret Key and pasting it in my appsettings.yaml file. Since the appsettings.yaml file contains personal information, please don't store in your source control. I can also view and modify the source files in my QuickStart folder and see my changes when running that code example. The Ruby QuickStart launcher will directly open the embedded signing code example page, which I'll show later. Here's the code for the embedded signing in the app/services/esign folder. On line 95, I'll change the name of the DocuSign document from Lorem Ipsum to Hello World and save my changes. This name will be shown when the document is presented in the browser. Moving on to step 2 from the README, which says, 2. In your command line environment, switch to the folder CD QuickStart folder. I'll use Terminal to navigate to my extracted QuickStart folder, Tally Customer Portal-Ruby. Next, I'll install all dependencies using step 3, Bundler Install. Now I can run the Ruby launcher using step 5, Rails S, and view the application with step 6, open a browser to localhost on port 3000. The QuickStart will automatically attempt to authorize the user using the authorization code grant flow when first run. I see the consent window from this application, Tally Customer Portal. This consent window grants the app permission to perform actions on behalf of the user within the signature scope. This is required to call most e-signature API endpoints, including the first of our code examples, embedded signing. All QuickStarts are set up to run this example when they first launch. When the user selects Accept to grant that permission, DocuSign gives the app an authorization code that can be exchanged for an OAuth access token, which DocuSign requires for API calls. QuickStart also adds a DocuSign private key.txt file and configures my appsettings.yaml file for JSON Web Token or JWT grant, so I could select that flow after completing embedded signing. Once the user has granted consent to an application, they will not be prompted again for actions under the specified scope unless consent is revoked. Now that I've authorized the app and received an access token, I see the embedded signing code example. Embedded signing demonstrates how to collect signatures directly within my app without emailing the signer. Also linked are the API methods used, envelopes create and envelope views create recipient. The links will take me to the Developer Center pages that describe those methods. The link to the source file will show me the Ruby code for embedded signing in GitHub. The signer email and name have been pre-populated with my developer account information, but I could choose to change those values. Once I select Submit to send the envelope, I'm taken directly to the document. Now I'll scroll to the bottom of the document and see that the document name is no longer Lorem Ipsum, but has been changed to Hello World. I'll sign the document and select Finish. I'm then taken to the Signing Complete page. I'll select Continue. Now I see the Ruby Launcher homepage with all the code examples. I can run the other code examples as well. All these code examples are also available in the other Quick Start launchers: Bash, C#, Java, Node, PHP, PowerShell, and Python. If you have any questions about how to develop your integration with DocuSign, here are some resources. I recommend checking out the Developer Center how-to guides, going to Stack Overflow, reaching out to support, or signing up for API office hours. That's it. Thanks for tuning in. If you're watching from our YouTube channel, please post questions and comments below the video or email us at developers@docusign.com.